Tonight, strike up the band.
Yeah, baby.
Cue the dancers. And raise your voice in song.
I just love that song.
Because you're about to see 20 totally unique performers with skills you won't believe. Including...
I'm sorry, you're calling this comedy?
Plus, which member of our cast is hiding a Japanese TV past?
I don't know, but he is a cute little thing.
Find out while the rest of our celebrity panel basks in their own memories of showbiz glory.
I could sing at 6 years old. I was perfect pitch.
truTV presents World's Dumbest Performers. And the show starts now.
What do you want to watch, honey?
Anything but that Angola channel.
Oh, but I love the Angola channel.
It's lucky you're good in bed.
Welcome to Puppet, okay? The dancing puppet.
Our countdown begins with a puppeteer performance on an Angolan TV show.
A nasty booty shaking puppet show? Oh, lock up your Barbies. This is going to be good.
This puppet amuses me. Make him my new Secretary of Defense.
Coming down. Oh, yeah.
Oh, bring it on down.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, bring it on down.
I like this.
Oh, yeah.
Baby puppet can give some ass.
Oh, yeah.
I have definitely fallen for guys with less substance and worse moves.
Can you feel it? Oh, oh.
Oh, wow.
Make it stop. Isn't there a musical guest?
I need to give me a little bit of more. Boom, 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 boom. Shake, 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 shake.
Should he be letting that puppet do that to his face?
No, I'm in a committed relationship.
No, no,
okay.
I ain't done, no.
Good, good. That was enough.
Thank you, thank you.
Come here. Talk to me.
I just feel like I need to take a shower now.
Yes, give it to me. Go.
Who's your puppet? Huh? Who's your puppet?
Oh, my God!
In Russia, a group of ex-soldiers show off their military skills.
No. Hold there. Wait. Hey.
One veteran wants to prove that he can still perform his old martial arts tricks.
You're going to kick his hand?
Yeah, hit it.
Okay.
My foot.
Okay.
Here.
Yet, hold hand in front of face so I know where to aim.
Yes, perfect.
You're going to kick his hand?
Yes.
Any reason they need to be shirtless here, or is that just like a bonus for the viewer?
Okay, stand back.
Hey!
You're in there!
All right, now let's see him shoot a gun.
I swear, I can't go to one Russian dirt road bathing suit party without something weird happening.
You're in there!
Ooh, nice depth perception, Fedor.
You know, if you ever want to kick your friend in the face and make it look like an accident, this is the way to do it.
Why did you kill me?
The earth seems to be moving a lot more dramatically for him.
I'm okay.
You see, he's okay.
Yes, I'm okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Why did you move? I didn't move.
Great job, Sergei. Now we have to drive Vladimir to nearest hospital, which is 400 miles away.
You shouldn't have moved.
I didn't move. Stop saying that.
Yes, you did.
Oh. You idiot!
America, suck it, Rocky, and your brother, too.
What's up? Welcome to Redumosity, the world's first show where we show you clips.
I'm some guy. Joining me as always is my pizzanel. Say hi to Nice T, Jenny Eastside, and special guest, the didgeridoo.
I'm Australian, that's cool, right? Party!
Have you ever been like, I want to jump off the roof? Well, this guy did just that.
You know, I know the Kansas State campus a little bit, and it looks to me like he's jumping from the roof of the Science Center to the roof of the new library.
Bitches.
That's like a 15-foot gap.
You want me to jump back?
Oh, yeah, jump back!
I've been shot, I've been stabbed, I've been trampled, charged by Cape Buffaloes. I have yet to do a roof jump.
Stratton, as your legal counsel, I advise you to not do this.
Dude, I've crunched the numbers. The physics just don't make sense.
Go, pussy!
Dude, this is a bad idea. But if you don't do it, you're a pussy!
Dude, that's higher than that.
Listen to the smart guy in the group. He's the one using his beard to point to things.
Listen to me.
I'm recording. You're recording, you have to go.
It's the law. If somebody's recording, you have to do something dumb.
You gotta go. You want me to throw you a beer? Maybe you will.
Oh, ooh, good luck finding chest band-aids.
You want me to throw you a beer?
Oh, you guys didn't catch me.
Yo, you guys didn't catch me at all.
You guys didn't catch me at all.
You were supposed to jump. There was never a catching. You changed the rules.
Perhaps the most unfortunate part of this is that Stratton's thesis was on roof jumping.
Kapop slam!
You're hilarious!
Word.
I think he's cute!
You would!
This has been Redumosity, the funniest show ever!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Miss Asian North America pageant! The most beautiful Asian ladies in North America!
North American, Asian, pick a title, pick a country. Let's just go with a continent. How about that?
Please welcome to the stage our beautiful Asian contestants. Come on, ladies.
Does anyone know why the dude is just hanging around bouncing his pecs? Who's enjoying that?
Everyone is from North America.
Okay, next contestant.
Bring me the third one from the left.
Okay, the left.
Yes.
Yeah, that one?
And the fourth.
Yeah. Four.
Immediately.
Four. Okay.
Hi.
You know you're sexy when you give a nerd a nosebleed.
And the first question for you is, Japan has recently experienced tsunami. What would you do to build up tourism?
If I were to be Miss Asia, North America, I would personally visit Japan.
I was gonna do that social media line. Damn it.
I will personally Twitter the tsunami and tell it to stop.
I will also write articles and post videos introducing the rich cultural heritage.
She gonna do all that while wearing a bikini?
Okay, let's hear it now for contest number one, ladies and gentlemen. She did a good job, I think. A nice warm round of applause there.
Uh-oh. That's what you get for wearing knockoffs, honey. Where'd you buy them? China?
Uh-oh.
Those shoes are tricky. That's why they're usually only worn by professionals.
Let's give it up for us.
Ooh, man. Let's get the lady's perspective.
She totally fell. She did.
I've been known to get all wobbly like that after having beers, right? Beers! Where do you guys come up with this stuff?
She did a nice job.
Uh-oh.
Despite her smooth recovery, contestant number one is eliminated.
Some people would say that ending up on your back in a beauty pageant should actually increase your score instead of eliminating you from the competition. So I, for one, am demanding a recount.
Okay, let's hear it again.
In Canada, visiting U.S. Marines perform a precision drill.
This is very important. I think we all know how many battles were won by who is the best gun twirler.
Oh, that is amazing.
Did you see that? He is so unbelievable.
Shh, I'm watching, bitch. At what point does he take out all the other guys?
No. Oh.
Not good.
The few, the proud, the butterfinger.
No.
Oh. Break it down with Roger Lodge.
Okay, this deserves a closer look. Now, the rifle wants to go from this guy to this guy. But first, some extra fancy gun waggling's gotta take place, which seems to hypnotize this guy. So now when the rifle flies, he's got the slip grip and womp, and the piece is bouncing off the concrete, which is never good.
It looked really good.
Got it.
And that's a story of how we accidentally invaded Canada.
Hey, nice catch, hoser. No wonder we always beat your ass in hockey. Hi-ho, trollop, away!
Will you quit changing the channels and watch something?
Oh, we just want to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Ooh, late night gospel music.
Not again.
God richly bless you. Here's Henrietta and Myrna Newdorf right now singing.
People killing black music since Elvis.
Oh, oh, killing the funk, baby. You're killing the funk.
Ooh, sang it, sisters.
This is sacrilegious in every way.
That Jesus Christ is born.
Loving that energy. Loving that. Give me more of that. Give me more. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, Henrietta. Working like that, baby.
Shepherds fear and tremble low above the earth. They rang the angel chorus.
Myrna.
Our Savior's
over birth. Here.
Go,
yeah, there you go.
We're no longer welcome on the mountain. Why'd you make me sing this song?
Jesus Christ is born.
All right, that's enough of that. What else is on?
Why you gotta change it so fast, damn it, woman?
Shitara and Himura are part of an extreme comedy troupe in Japan. Today's sketch?
Hi.
Chugging a bottle of soda in under 3 seconds.
What does that guy tell his barber when he goes in? Hey, can you make me look like a caricature of my ethnicity, please?
Come on, please, just put your shirt back on. You're making Brad look good.
What?
I'm sorry, you're calling this comedy?
Dude,
it's a Coke, not a fine Bordeaux.
Throws up in conversation and keeps going.
For his third attempt, Himura decides to switch from a bottle to a glass.
Please note, his teeth are getting more and more rotten with each cup of soda.
Hey,
a huge difference. Okay, Japan, why don't we stick to sushi, anime, and creepy sex stuff? There must be something good on.
The black bear was roaming through.
Ooh, wildlife alert!
Early Sunday morning, right here along Miles Road, a jogger saw what they thought was a black bear, immediately called police, but when police showed up, no sign of the bear.
The black bear was roaming through Tina Marison's backyard. This recreation identifies how witnesses say the bear escaped into the woods.
Look, I'm the news editor here, and I call the shots. I don't care if there's a bear there or not. You're a journalist. Make it work.
Did George Lucas or Peter Jackson do the CGI for that bear?
You can just tell us a bear was there. We'll totally believe it.
Tina was too stunned to get a picture, but this is what the bear probably looked like, except real.
Oh, now why the bear gotta be black? I'm playing. This whole shit is stupid.
You can't see me, right? I'm not in the shot, right? I want this to look good.
Tina still can't believe how close she came to a bear.
I lost it. I started shaking. I started shaking.
That bear should have called 911 because there was a human in his woods. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I just blow your mind?
Cleveland Metro Parks naturalist Carly Martin explains that black bears can be on the ground or can climb in trees. She's never seen one, but came close.
Then I found bear scat.
Bear scat.
Scat is the good nature word for poop.
What? Wait, what?
It means okay?
Todd Meany, Fox 8 News.
You know, some days the news should just show up and go, we got nothing, and then put on a Seinfeld rerun.
Everyone knows that a cardboard cutout is no substitute for the real thing. What's this crap? Nice try.
Rawr! What do you think? Does that help?
Mmm, black and bear.
Now I know what to get you for your birthday.
Oh, you're too good to me.
I know.
Two teenagers prepare to perform at a breakdancing competition in Israel.
Wow, Tel Aviv wrecking crew in the house.
There's a Israeli breakdancing. Breakdancing's Brooklyn, Fort Apache, New York, you know, Latino black.
Oh! How do you say ouch in Hebrew?
Yeah! Oh.
Go Hiram, go Moshe, go to the hospital.
Is he okay? Can someone get it? Is there a doctor here? We're in Israel. There's got to be a doctor here. Yeah! Oh!
You know you're really f***ed up when you hit your face so hard that your shoes fly off.
People will do anything to get out of the Israeli army.
Ooh, talk about a religious experience. Tell me something good, nice tea.
Well, it's interesting to note that decades of mutual political and economic support between America and Israel has led to a kind of cultural symbiosis between the two countries.
I mean, that guy got mad busted. It was like, boom!
We'll be right back with more of this thing we're doing. It's awesome.
Please rise for the national anthem at this Pennsylvania high school fair.
Okay, Will Appring is gonna sing the Star Spangled Banner for us. Y'all set, Will?
Thank you. Oh, can you see by the dawn's early light?
The key to singing the national anthem correctly is to start as low as possible. Otherwise, the terrorists win.
Nothing says patriotism like having to read the lyrics.
This part's easy. Just stay low. Just relax. Just go with it. Nothing too dramatic. Just stay low. A little higher notes. You're gonna have to hit some higher notes. Just go a little higher. Drop it a notch, bro.
Oh, for
God.
A
oh, God.
Day through the night that our flag was still there.
It's like he keeps going back and forth through puberty.
Still got a courtesy clap at the end. Really speaks to people's humanity.
He's a good boy.
I love you.
It's the national anthem. He butchered it. He should be neutered. He should be a castrata.
Stop on our countdown, 1979, for a visit with a dumb performer we all know and love.
I love potato stick.
Hey, who's this guy?
I don't know, but he is a cute little thing.
He looks familiar.
You guys, that's me.
Oh, my God!
Wait, that's you?
Yeah, before I grew the bandana.
Wow, who knew Leif was such a pretty girl? She really let herself go.
I might change teams for this.
Hey, Leif, do you keep stuff in your pockets with pants that tight, or do you have to carry around a little handbag?
Leif was made for dancing, and apparently shilling potato sticks.
I want to dance with you.
Hey, it paid the bills.
I want to dance with you and this.
So, it'll be a threesome.
I want to dance with you and this.
When this young man says he wants to dance with you, you say, I'm on board.
How far we've fallen. I love Leif. What the f*** happened to you, Leif?
Idaho potato ga slim ni natta. Shin hatsubai, Idaho potato stick.
I love potato stick.
Hey, don't worry about it, Leif. We've all had to do commercials like this at one point or another. Having bedroom problems? Then you need tiger penis.
You make me feel so happy.
Remember, it's not real tiger penis unless it has my face on it.
Hey, Todd, what you talking about?
I'm talking about Hickamore Robot Love Dog.
So what else is on?
Skating with the Stars in Norway. Oh my God, I love this.
Cortes, Kaplan, Yadus, Comandera.
Talk about Norwegian wood.
Why don't we turn things over to Tonya? T, take it away.
It's a balance issue. He lifts her up, and she is over here, and she's supposed to be over here. So what we wanted to do is go this way and come straight down, and they went this way and fall. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am.
Dorothy, Dorothy, speak to me. Speak to me, Dorothy. Dorothy.
Cancel my trip to Norway. Dorothy would no longer be able for private entertainment.
Luckily, Dorothy only has some bruising, and she and her partner are able to skate on, finishing in fourth place. A few weeks later, they return to the show.
Og så tror jeg etter hvert jeg tenkte at Guriland, nå skal jeg ned på Ulvå sykehus, og jeg ser ut som en bimbo.
You didn't look like a bimbo. You looked hot. I'm into that 80.
Frankly, I never thought that Dorothy Skoppel had what it took to win the Norwegian version of Skating with the Stars. I was a fan of Ingvar Gundersen from the very first. Yeah!
Dear Diary, today I had the totally most embarrassing day that anyone has ever had in the history of high school ever. First, in phys ed, Coach Munsazal, can you handle this high jump? And I'm like, totally. I was all like, ha ha ha, but I was so pissed. And Coach is like, where's your positive attitude? And I'm like, where's your real job? So then, at cheerleading? I was seriously beasting it, but one of my spotters, Keith, gets distracted looking at I don't know what. Ask anyone. Keith's nose totally got in the way of my foot.
Are you kidding me? Keep your legs closed for once, will you?
So embarrassing.
Ready?
So last thing of the day is graduation, and Jenny's like, I totally dare you to do a dance when you get your diploma. And I'm like, yeah, watch me.
Marianne Sear. Marianne!
Oh, that was my bad.
Marianne.
Okay.
I'm good.
But who cares? Next year, community junior college, bitches. Nothing embarrassing ever happens there.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the annual stallion show here in Verden. Today's entertainer is Luma, the pony lion.
Oh, cute. I want one.
You may ask yourself, what is a pony lion? And the answer, a freak of nature.
Cross-dressing ponies is a first, even on this show.
Oh, those Germans are kinky.
She has the tawny color and the mane, but also the hooves. The pony lion also does tricks, like this one. Look at it. Look at the trick.
Now you listen to me, you little pony lion freak, or no sexy times for you.
The pony lion also does other tricks, like this. She hops like the bunny. Hop, hop, or like a child with a small limp.
When does the part come where he acts like the king of the jungle and mauls this woman to death?
The pony lion also tap dances, like the Gregory Hines.
Whatever you do, don't let my kids see this. I have enough problems picking up after the dog.
What else does the pony lion do? He hunts for his food, like now, hunting for his food.
Ooh, act afraid of me, I'll chase you, I'm the lion.
Help me, this wild beast is going to kill me.
And after the hunt, the pony lion lies in the dirt and rolls around like a kitten to say, forgive me, please.
Ooh, I like the part when the pony has a seizure. Yay!
Yes, but can he walk on his hind legs? Behold the two-legged pony lion! Yes, he can! Jump to the hoop! Jump! Yes! Don't do that! Get away from there!
Was he trained to smell that pile of crap? Or was that him improvising?
Stop that pony lion! Stop it! Come on! Move! Move! You may ask, what is more amazing than the pony lion? And I answer, nothing!
Yakimbara fish chews.
Senri no michi mo ganbatte.
A triple lots of fish flavor in every chew.
Shinpai shinai de, shiaose ni.
Be happy. Sayonara.
Our countdown takes us all the way to Algeria for, what else? Another breakdancing competition.
Shake it! Hey! 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 Ho! Come on!
Break into Algerian boogaloo!
Come on!
The last time I checked my swatch, it wasn't 1985 anymore.
In rehearsal, the guys had their big move all worked out.
Okay, Ellie, yeah, pick me up. That's right. And swing me, and then toss me, and I'll land and start dancing.
So his friends are just gonna spin him out there, and then he's gonna land on his hands and go into some weird breakdance move, right? I mean, that shouldn't be a problem.
Perfect.
It's like they were throwing out the trash.
Come on, you gotta practice things or else some people are gonna get hurt. Practice, practice, practice.
You know, on the bright side, he made it into the circle. That's a win.
What say you, Pizzano?
Yo, when I first saw this, I was all like, wow. And now I'm all like, okay.
That is one broke breaker right there.
Oh. Yeah, I'm hungry. Does anyone have like a fruit water or a vitamin air?
No, I'm okay.
Oh, he got up.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he didn't.
Never mind. I'm okay.
The daring performer is unharmed.
I'm worried about these kids spending too much time on their break dancing. They're gonna fall behind on their gang activity.
He put the gun right up here to my head, and that's where it was when he pulled the trigger.
Hello, and welcome to another episode of Shot in a Theater. I'm your host, the late Abe Lincoln. You know, the guy on the penny. We now present a recreation of actual events that took place at the Sarasota Seniors Theater dress rehearsal for the play of Mice and Men.
Okay, so William, you're gonna take that fake gun, all right? And when Fred says his line, you're gonna shoot him in the old noggin, okay? Easy peasy lemon squeezy, let's try it.
Okay, Lenny, tell me about the rabbits, George.
You get to tend the rabbits, Lenny.
Oh my God. Wait, cut scene, cut!
Egads, the foolish prop master has brought a pistol he thinks was unloaded, but he is grievously mistaken.
Oh my God, are you okay? Help, the gun was
wrong.
Help!
You shot him with a real bullet. Are you insane? Where did this gun come from anyway?
The bullet punctures the octogenarian's scalp, glances off his lower skull, then emerges to pass through his upper ear.
I thought I killed him. I thought I killed him. And I just said, oh.
Luckily, this actor is a poorer shot than John Wilkes Booth. That jerkwad.
Are you all right?
Go
Are you all right?
Oh,
yes,
okay.
Yes.
Mr. Kellerman is whisked to the hospital.
Come on, hurry.
And makes a full recovery.
If the gun had been pointed in any slighter different direction, it would have been disastrous.
Of course, the show must go on, and on opening night, a young 70-year-old performs in Fred's place. This has been Shot in a Theater. Stuff the damned sound effects, please!
Sometimes all it takes is a little liquid courage to inspire a dumb performer.
Oh, he's terrified.
After a few beers, James has decided to cure a lifelong fear of horses by saddling up in front of his friends.
Will you sit on the damn fence facing the horse?
What this guy needs to do is, like, think of the horse as a girl instead of a horse, you know?
Can you stand on your other foot?
Not really.
Hold the horn.
Is he someone who can even walk in real life?
Why is he all moving?
I don't know, he's a horse.
I am so scared.
What you so scared of horses for? Ooh, looks like your fears was warranted after all.
Instead of horses, he should probably just have a fear of gravity.
That horse looked embarrassed. And this is a creature that s*** as it walks. So that's saying a lot.
Not funny.
That was amazing. Tell me something good, Jenny Eastside.
Oh, no, I've got nothing. And I think this guy might be dead.
Oh, God! How long was I out?
Your accent's gone.
Your accent's gone. Well, that's gonna do it for us here at Redumosity. You keep being dumb out there, and we promise we'll return the favor.
The icon to the game, Mr. Angelo Mosco.
At a Canadian Football League charity luncheon, retired former rivals Joe Capp and Angelo Mosca prepare to give speeches. The two have feuded since a 1963 championship game when Angelo delivered a late hit against one of Joe's teammates.
Y'all fight from 1963, really?
Throw the flag, ref. That's textbook unsportsmanlike conduct.
Did you really have to punch him? Just do what I do. Give him the finger.
If you're watching a fight that involves one cane but no pimps, it's a bad fight.
Horsemanship!
Let me feign senility so I can get away with what I just did. Sportsmanship!
I've never carried this grudge. He's carried a grudge for 48 years.
It's frickin' 48 years ago. Let it go! Oh my God. I mean, did this guy take your virginity or what?
Okay.
Yeah, I hold the grudge for a long time. I named my dog Angelo, and I kicked the out of that dog every day.
Yeah, it's true.
Not only did you turn an entire room against you, I think that's PETA on line one.
Thank you very much.
I beat my dog. Good night, see you at the merch table.
What's great up with a controversy?
You know, if these guys had been as competitive and aggressive on the field, Canadian football would be more like football.
Ooh, the national anthem.
By the dawn's early light.
Do we have to watch this? The singers always f*** it up.
You know, shut up and salute.
The rocket's red.
I can't watch this.
Okay. Oh, hey, look, it's Frank.
Ooh, I like a man who knows how to use his gun.
Well, that's easy. Anyone could do that.
They say that teamwork is the work a team does. Let's see if that's the case.
Wait, what's this?
He fell! You just described what happened in an interesting way. I don't even know where I am right now. All I know is you should download me Fart app.
This is like my new favorite show.
Okay, I can't tell. I'm gonna go watch TV in the other room.